Heat are out of Miami and into an interconference game. 2K Sports brings you Friday night NBA action. This is Kevin Harlan along courtside with Brent Berry and Greg Anthony. We've got David Aldridge on our sideline. To take a look at the Celtics. So important to get off on the right foot. New year, new season. These guys have done it.
And you know, for Boston, they're proving that all the talk we heard about them in the preseason was warranted. What a roll this group's been on here early on.
And don't count on that coming to an end anytime soon. The talent level of this squad is off the charts. And with the momentum they're gathering here early in the year, it could steamroll through the season.
Now the starting group for the visitors. They've got ABC. Miracle Man is out there with the kid. Then it's Magician. And it's the Monster in at the five spot. Now Wilson. After Jaylen Brown's three-pointer that didn't go. And that one's good. The Monster. Everyone's excited to see these two monster teams battle it out. You know, Greg, whoever comes out on top tonight will have really made a statement to the league.
And, Kevin, no matter what happens, this is a great opportunity for both teams. They say iron sharpens iron. The only way you get better is by facing challenging opponents. Changing ends quickly, he's rewarded with a high percentage look.
Yeah, the defense trying to do their best to slow him down, but when he gets room like that, you got to look out.
Now, here's Tatum. Six on the shot clock. The Celtics need to get a shot off. And here's Brogdon from the arc. Carries it from three-point range.
Everything in sync right now for Brogdon. Nice base, good timing, good release.
Wilson, no good with the layup. And here's Tatum. He'll bring it up for Boston. It's a three-point game. Just over a minute and a half played here in this one. Here's Johnson, outside to Brogdon. That three off the mark.
Ooh, he missed an easy chance to put some points on the board. He won't get a much better look at that kind of shot again here probably tonight.
And Jaylen Brown is such a force on the offensive end. Hard to keep that guy out of the paint. Terrific finisher at the rim.
Now here's Leonard. Jason Tatum missing his last shot.
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game.
Well, there's a swagger out there. You can see it on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either. Nice angle on that replay with the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Over in the corner, Williams. He's off on that one. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. And there's the call on Malcolm Brogdon.
Personal foul.
That's his first foul.
You know what? Tried to step in and cut him off, but just didn't get there quick enough.
From the inbound, Miracle Man, no good. And maybe the only weakness for Brown is his handle on the ball.
And it's something that he's worked on every offseason. Still, though, susceptible to turnovers while dribbling. That's one of the very few weaknesses in his game.
Shots good by Wilson.
Boy, he is looking confident. Boston. Love how they're... using him so far.
Yeah, right now I don't see any let up. Think he's gonna just keep putting his foot on that gas pedal tonight.
And now the first time out called here for Boston.
Trying to snap them out of this little slump.
Well, they can't find the net right now, and all they need, I think, is just to get one to go, get back on track.
Now here's Brogdon. The rim rattling two-handed jam.
At 6'5", Brogdon capable of getting up there. We don't see it all that often, but a nice dunk.
To the paint. Here's Tyler. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Jason Tatum.
Well, after the offense, it's getting some veteran help. Gallinari and Brogdon bring shooting, and Brogdon's another playmaker on the floor.
Here's what Boston's going with right now. Al Horford has checked in for Williams. Gallinari comes in for Jason Tatum. And Marcus Smart is subbed in for Brogdon.
First team foul.
Now here's Smart. Defense is right there. Tries it from 19.
Really having a difficult time getting anything to fall.
Good. for the basket, starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
And down it goes, jamming that one home.
Assisted by.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
Yeah, the bully ball tonight has paid dividends. Highly effective down there with the physical play.
Really left alone that time.
And the insane peripheral vision there. And if anyone's open, even for an instant, Magic's
terrifying in the first.
Now, here's DJ. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Pass to Tyler. Gallinari with the steal. Inside. And it's Brown missing.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points.
Number 16.
Just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
And how about breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk?
A nice way to pad that lead a little more. You're right. Now, here's Johnson. No good with the elbow jumper. There's 1:26 left in the first quarter. Here's Money. He's covered by Brown. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
And there's the whistle. That goes on fire. That's his first foul. Some changes for Boston. Grant Williams comes in for Brown. And Derek White subbed in for Johnson. The visitors on defense. They lead by 11. Here's Smart. And it's blocked. Here is Mr. Incredible, White covering. Here's Tyler, good for the basket.
Assist
starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
18.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
Knocks it loose. Flash passes to Tyler, and the powerful one-handed slam.
Their play on both ends has been superb. We'll see if they can maintain the momentum.
Like tonight, that all the hustle plays have meant so much to this team. Now just sustain some of that energy and keep comfortable.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Coaching staff probably most proud of the effort of this team on both ends of the floor here tonight.
A nice shot by Gallinari. The visitors with the ball. 15-point game. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Really on the right play defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
Shooting for the away team.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
And they've clearly been the aggressors here early on, drawing fouls and working themselves to the line.
Here's White. Out of hand on it. Out of bounds. So it's ball as Boston keeps possession. To get it to Smart and does, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
For a guy who's still working on his range, love to see Smart attacking on the interior.
Here's Money. Some solid defense from Gallinari. And an overpowering first quarter effort, already a double digit advantage.
Result
up by 15.
Wow.
And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of the spread.
Headed to the floor.
Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. And looking at what we've seen so far, guys, from the visiting team, what do you think?
Stingy on the defensive end in that first quarter. They were just getting up into people.
Just a great job, really, of making the game ugly, trying to muck it up a little bit out there.
Williams. Tatum and Williams up in the forward spot. Ogden out there with Derek White, and it's Williams at the five. Is in the game for the Celtics. And let's head over
number
to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. Now, Marcus Smart is not shy with his philosophy. He says it takes little talent to play defense, but a whole lot of want to. Get every 50-50 ball, take charges, be a great teammate, compete, never be okay with losing. Kevin, he has always walked the walk, too.
He has. Defensive player of the year. He's a terrific player. No question about it. David, thank you.
This is one where the second foul is probably going to cost you some minutes in this game.
Getting another opportunity here to see that powerful rejection.
Magic. And this is how you protect and grow a lead by making a huge effort on that end of the floor.
Looking at who's out there now for the Celtics. Jaylen Brown checked in for Williams. And it's Johnson in for White. And that outstanding drive and finish brought to you by Mobile One.
And that finish sums up the whole game. They have a big lead due to execution on drives just like that.
He gets that one. Brogdon's got 7 points.
Brogdon inside, never rushed, effective with the soft touch.
ABC, a shot missing. Great D that time from Tatum. And Jason Tatum seems GA like he's on the verge of being a superstar in the league.
And Kevin, some would say he is already there. It feels like he's going to win an MVP in the next 5 years. He's already shown he can lead a team to the finals. They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Stripped away. Down low. And he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
And the gamble paying off.
Oh.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot to free throws. For Malcolm Brogdon, he comes from a family, Greg, where education comes first.
And love Malcolm earning his degree plus a master's while in college. His dad and brother, lawyers, his mom involved in higher education. Brogdon, maybe the smartest guy in the NBA.
We have just a few games in the books, Brent. What are coaches right now looking for from their team, from their players?
Well, I think you're still trying to figure out what your identity is, Kevin. You've played a few games. You're trying a few different rotations. You still want to do that over the course of the next 25 games before you really settle into what you know is going to give you the best chance offensively and defensively and win game.
Celtics trail by 17. And Tatum with the basket on the assist by Johnson. Johnson's got 3 assists now in this one.
An incredible leaper at 6'8". Tatum is difficult to stop down low. And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
Here's Tatum. Now a timeout called by Boston. They come into this having outplayed the Clippers last game.
I like their aggression. Aggressiveness in that one. No one's going to give you anything. You've got to go out and take it.
And going back and watching that game, there was not one spot on the floor that they did not own.
Give them a hand.
We're just over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. And that basket is going to count. Goaltending the official call.
That's a very close call. I'm sure he thinks it's a clean block, but looks like it was on the way down.
Here's Miracle Man. He's guarded by Brogdon.
Celtics foul.
And a couple years ago, the NBA played with a 72-game schedule. Think the NBA will ever shorten the number of games long-term and go back to that number?
I don't know, Kevin, but this idea of the mid-season tournament seems to be gaining more and more traction, and there's a lot more interest in what it would do to the competitiveness of the middle part of the season. And I think we're all for something like that, where something's on the line and we see guys elevated in that element.
He's tried to get it going, but the shots simply have not been there. Nothing seems to be falling.
Good on the triple.
Solid in the first. Fantastic here in the second. He was just waiting for the moment.
Here's Tyler. This is it to DJ. And DJ hugs it down.
Good presence there. Already in his shooting motion, he spotted the open man and made the unselfish play.
And That's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. And some changes in. For the Celtics. Al Horford is checked in for Williams. Molinari comes in for Tatum. And Marcus Smart is subbed in for Brogdon. Now, well, here's Johnson. No points in the game yet for him. And the shot goes in.
Yeah, they've raised their shooting percentage in this quarter, and they're starting to get on track.
And it's DJ missing. And so Horford will bring it up for the Celtics. They trail by 14. Molinari against Wilson. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
And when 6'10", Danilo Gallinari drafted all the way back in 2008, a shooter with his size was rare.
Well, it was rare. Now we're seeing more and more guys able to do this, but there's certainly a ton of value in Gallo's efficiency and his size and consistency on the perimeter.
And it's Brown missing. It's been a nice stretch for them offensively.
I mean, the communication's great. The movement's been really good. This is solid team basketball. Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
And there's the foul. He's on Mr. Incredible.
Number 18.
That is his first foul of the game.
Personal foul.
White, he's checked in for Johnson.
Team foul.
1:32 left now here in the second.
For the Celtics.
The Celtics shoot their fifth and sixth free throws of the game.
And they had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
And
working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
Now you can tell he's feeling confident right now at the line, and when he's on, he can be lights out.
Celtics trailed by 12. Shoots from 14. Rebound by Tyler.
Now that's just enough defensive pressure on him to throw off that shot. I bet he gets a good look at it next time and hits it.
Flash passes to Tyler, and it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Total letdown by the D. Can't leave the bucket unprotected.
Absolutely. And it attacks an easy 2 points onto the lead.
Will not find a higher percentage opportunity than that.
And the basket by Money.
One of the more skilled offensive players that is on the floor here tonight. Not an easy fella to hold in check.
Money's gone 4 for 5 from the floor tonight. Just one miss. Now here's Smart. Tight defense on him. The shot, no good. Smart's gotten just one of his 4 attempts from the floor tonight. The putback, DJ on the follow. DJ's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Here's Brown. Got a piece of it. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. And DJ throws it down hard.
And how about just floating to the rim on that slam?
Boy, when he gets up, I mean, he gets up. And that's a foul called on
Money. Number 20.
That's his first foul of the game. And the bonus will go to the free throw line.
Oh, no. He's the last guy you want to put on the line. You can just about book the points every time he steps up there.
Celtics making a switch here. Williams is checked in.
And the vertical that Brown has is pretty impressive, as relentless a finisher as you'll find in our league. Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
It's stolen. Money passes to DJ. Off with the layup.
Oh, that's a golden opportunity to finish on the break, and he blows
that's
it.
The end of the
completely lost focus. You can't.
All right, David, thank you. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the third quarter.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, folks. Ernie Johnson checking out the visiting team. Kenny, how'd you feel about it?
They scored very effectively. With the exception of ball movement and play calling, they were able to exploit multiple weaknesses.
And that should...
And with the second half upon us. We'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. You know, guys, Malcolm Brogdon has been exceptional here tonight.
We've definitely been challenging the defense here early on, not settling for anything outside.
Yeah, you want these kind of nights where you can start to see those openings before they happen.
Get out there, Miracle Man. And there's the monster. And it's ABC. And it's Wilson in at the three. Oh, what an impressive dribble drive. That replay brought to you by Mobile One.
And I just love his competitiveness he's showing there. Team might be down, but a drive like that could spark them.
Here's Tatum. Another shot. And the layup is up and in. Tatum's got his second bucket.
Now that's leadership. The Tatum reads shot trajectories well and pounces on opportunities to grab second chance points.
Stolen by Wilson. And they're moving it up. Throws it up high.
And wasting no time in transition. Really pushing the pace.
Second half just getting started. About a minute played. Brogdon outside. Outside Tatum. Knocked away. Williams trying to break free. Here's Miracle Man. Covered by Johnson. Miracle Man, good.
And Matador defense, that's one of the easiest shots he is ever going to see.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. Brent, how has size now affected the way the game is
played? Well, if I could just take a detour, Kevin, I would tell you it's skill that has affected the way the game is played. I mean, this has always been a tall man's game, and usually it's been dominated by the biggest guys, but that's not the case anymore. So you look at 6'4 to 6'7 guys who are skilled to shoot, pass, and dribble. That's what every team is looking for, and that's the way the modern NBA team, especially a championship caliber team, is made.
Here's Brown. Lays it up off the glass. Brown's got his third basket of the night.
And the craftiness of Brown, just so creative at picking apart the defense with his ball handling.
Number six.
It is good.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
Now, here's Johnson. Not a lot of room. A floater. It's rebounded by Leonard. The pass to Miracle Man. And he goes right over Jaylen Brown and slams it down.
Oh, he is a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
That could be a contender for the dunk of the year, I think. On our AT&T 5G Slam Cam, you just saw an explosive highlight. The monster, no good. A difficult situation for Boston. Celtics passing it around. It's deflected, and he recovers it. And there's the bucket from Tatum. Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Tatum. Yeah, easy call.
Second personal foul.
And the first one drops.
First team foul. At the line.
He's perfect from the line this time. Guys, we've seen a lot of turnovers in this one.
Yeah, focus, focus, focus. Just make the simple play.
Number one.
Excellent on both ends of that play.
Yeah, the steal was sharp, but the slam topped it off.
And we say it time and time again, so I'll repeat it. Have to be careful with the ball, or this is what happens.
It's Brown on the wing. Wilson with the block. And that's it. Out of bounds. Boston will return possession.
Boston
the Celtics making a switch here.
Now Colin Howard's checked in. The Celtics.
So it's the Celtics now. Lock at six. Brogdon. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Brogdon's got 18 points in the game.
Maybe maybe he's thinking at this point, man, somebody's got to help me. I can't do this all by myself.
Now here's Johnson, guarded closely.
Away team.
Even from over here, you can see
one,
that one pretty clearly.
Second.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. First one falls for him. Al Horford has checked in for Boston. Marcus Smart comes in for Malcolm Brogdon. And both free throws good for Johnson. Here's Miracle Man. 16 points for him.
And the one hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. To the inside. To the middle. Here's Leonard. And then Leonard with the dunk.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
Pass to Tatum. Another steal.
2 minutes remaining.
Here's Wilson. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
Wilson.
He's got six.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block.
Now a timeout called by Boston.
And they're allowing too many points in the paint. Coach is going to let them hear about it.
The coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it. Make the adjustment.
White is checked in for the Celtics. Poked loose. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here.
You love the pressure he's putting on them. Almost had that steal.
Yeah, pestering right now. And that's going to pay some dividends. At some point, there's going to be a turnover.
Williams kicks to Horford. Outside, White. The high post shot. That one good for two.
That's definitely a shot that he has in his arsenal.
The visitors with the ball. Here's the monster. And he jams it after taking the nice feed on the run.
Pushing the action, getting others involved. He does it time and time again.
Nice to play with a point guard that takes pride in playmaking. It makes you move around just a little bit faster to get open spots.
Outside, White. Five on the clock. Here's Horford. And a miss there on the triple. The monster passes to Wilson. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Wilson's got eight.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
And it's out of bounds. Last touch by White.
The ball goes to the away team.
Puts it up off the inbound, and Boston with the rebound. Williams has got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Tatum wide open, he fires one. Sinks the three-pointer. 9 points in the game so far.
He was sitting back a little bit there in the first half, but feels like showtime now, and he's ready to put some major points up on the board.
Now here's Smart. Defense right on him. And it's blocked. Out of bounds. Celtics ball is blocked. Boston keeps possession. Williams, he's checked in for now.
Timeout. Away team. The craziest fans will get a t-shirt. Come on, everybody. Make some noise.
32 seconds left here in the third quarter. The kick out to Williams. Whoops, anticipated the pass. Turnover.
How about that? Give it up for Celtics Entertainment.
And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
Oh, the officials are all over that.
Second foul. Second team foul. Shooting
the first one falls.
Number 18. Two shots.
He's off on the second. And turnovers have been the issue for him.
You can see the coaches have gotten into him a little bit about this. They've got to do a better job of taking care of the ball.
To the paint and stolen by Tatum. Left side, Smart. Boston, no good that time either. And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead, and this one may already have been decided. Delivering the blowout. And fourth quarter basketball will be coming your way on two. Sports right after this. And there have been two very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. Smart's gotten just one of six shots to fall here. The two Williams are the four and the five. Johnson is out there with White, and it's Gallinari in at the three spot. That's the Boston five.
That's a bad miscue, but I think they've done a really good job keeping control of the ball throughout the game.
Now, here's Johnson. D right on him. And there's the foul. Goes on Mr. Incredible. That'll be his second foul of the game. Brett, we've seen star players continue to angle their way onto what some would call super teams. Is that good or bad for the league?
I think at some point that's going to probably play itself out. I mean, every organization, Kevin, quite frankly, is looking for the best talent they can. So if you could pile up three, four, five, you're going to do it. But at some point financially, it just doesn't make sense. So I think there's going to be a time when you're going to see that dissipate a little bit as teams put themselves together.
My goodness, that was absolutely filthy.
Ugh, nasty. This building is stunned. He dug deep, Greg, into his bag of tricks there. White looking around. Poked away. One-on-one here. Here's Mr. Incredible. Count that bucket. Mr. Incredible's got four this quarter.
Great effort and gets in a little razzle-dazzle at the end of that one.
Yeah, why not? Show a little creativity, get inside, move that ball around. Make sure you score.
And when you have this kind of size as a point guard, what a tremendous advantage. Magic can really match up with all five positions.
Behind the back and lays it in.
Johnson. He just slides in for the layup. Goes behind the back and then just up and in. Nicely done, young fella.
A nice shot by Tyler.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far.
Personal foul.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like there's some bad blood between those two.
Malcolm Brogdon's check. In for White. Rumors continue to fly about possible league expansion. Brent, any cities you'd like to see join the league?
Oh, man, there's a lot of great options out there, Kevin. But I would like to see the league go to 32 and have 16 in each conference. I think that would be great. And a city in the Pacific Northwest, it deserves a team. And I think you know where I'm talking about. Seattle.
Clearly struggling here with the foul. Still early. And just one more.
And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
And Brogdon straight it over the summer to the Celtics. I'm interested to see how he'll fit with the rest of the Celtics guards. They certainly have a deep rotation now and a lot of flexibility. Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
No, boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
First personal foul. First team foul. Shooting
first free throw is good.
Number 91 taking two shots.
And good on the second, so he makes them both. So far, we've seen them be a bit careless with the ball.
Simply put out of control. That's how they play thus far. They're going to have to reel it in and show some more discipline. And being over the limit this early really can affect your aggressiveness defensively. They have got to play under control.
the inbound, and he takes that one up and powers it through.
And kind of par for the course here, right? Coming through with a solid offensive game to help them get this lead.
There's Gallinari, and he finishes nicely on the loop.
Showing some nice body control, outstanding at keeping his composure and continuing to play at his speed is Gallinari.
To the inside, here's ABC. The Monster tipped back in for two. The Monster's got 12 points in just the second half.
A good board there, Kevin, but overall they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
Leonard with the steal. And here's the break. Here's Miracle Man. Marvelous lead pass, and he throws it down.
Beautiful transition offense there. That's execution at its best.
Yeah, once you burst through a seam like that, you got to look right towards the rim. Sweet play. I don't know if you push the panic button out, but that's the fourth personal, and he needs to stay aggressive out there. So going to be interesting to see how he plays moving forward.
Austin making a switch here. Griffin's checked in. We know, Greg, the league trending towards small ball, but some teams are having success playing two bigs up front.
And I think the key is having versatile big men. If they can space the floor and play in space, also be able to cover smaller players, why not get the added rebounding and rim protection?
Third personal foul.
First free throw is good. The Celtics making a switch here. Hauser's checked in.
Magic Johnson.
And Johnson drops them both. Here's Miracle Man. He's guarded by Brogdon. And it's Leonard with the jam.
A sharp pass to set up that high percentage shot in close.
Pass to Gallinari. And the foul goes on the Magician. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot two. And he knocks down the first one. Smart's checked in for the Celtics. And so he makes both from the line. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Here's ABC, rebounded by the Celtics. Here's Hauser, and he banks in the layup.
Sam Hauser.
Gallinari does such a great job of recognizing the floor space, and that time, credit him with the assist.
Miracle Man, Blake Griffin pulls it in, and here's Boston. And the basket by Hauser.
Sam Hauser.
Can't talk enough about the subtleties in that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
Extra on that one, fellas. Nobody's stopping that.
Not when he comes in there with that tomahawk. That's just too much force. Back to Johnson. It's deflected, and they'll keep possession. Oh, and he misses the dunk.
Well, you could tell right there he just wanted to go for the jam, but the defense too good. And distracting.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Gallinari.
That one on Gallinari.
And
right nowadays, there are so many options for the great high school basketball player in this country and overseas. Do you see the G League Ignite in similar ways as a positive overall?
Well, I think right now you'd have to say that the G League Ignite has been a successful experiment, and that run is going to continue. You get guys like Jalen Green, who drafted by the Houston Rockets and came in, had a sensational rookie season. That pathway has led him there, so I think they're doing a good job. The interesting thing, Kevin, to talk about is what colleges have done in response to that and what's going on in the NIL space. How does that change the dynamic in the future? Fantastic attack by Gallinari. Once he realizes the defense was cheating up, took advantage of it.
And the foul called on ABC. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, that's a bad move there. Stops the clock and puts the other side on the line.
And no good on the second free throw, so he goes 0 for 2 there.
Traditionally, we talk about power forwards. I mean, is that not Blake Griffin? It applies to every facet of his game.
And that put a hush over the crowd.
Wow, I mean, took these fans out of the game in the blink of an eye.
And he commits the intentional foul.
Yeah, not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
And Marcus Smart, GA, the very definition of a guy you love on your team, but hate to play against.
Yeah. And teams that go deep need that sort of presence. Smart is more than just an agitator, though. Great player who anyone would want to play alongside.
And the foul on the monster. Number 91. That will get him his fourth foul of the game. And during the bonus, we'll head to the line for two. Starting in 2021, referees were instructed to not reward players making overt, abrupt, or abnormal non-basketball moves, Brent. What'd you think of that?
Well, there are some guys who play abnormally, Kevin, so what are you going to do about those guys? No, I'm kidding. I think it's a great thing for shooters to try to gain some sort of advantage with how much advantage offensive players already have. It was getting a little bit out of control.
And some of what Smart gives this team doesn't always show up in the stat sheet, but he makes plays that help you win.
Here we go. And now, let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game, Miracle Man.
And his performance has been a jaw dropper. It must have been feeling great coming into the building tonight, because once he hit the court, it was all working for him. He was in a zone.
He silenced this crowd with an unreal display. His ability to drown out the noise and the hostility of an opposing crowd is pretty special. And the kid picks up the foul.
Second personal foul.
So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot two. And both free throws good for White. 52 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And Smart over to help. Stolen by Smart. And oh, here we go. Gallinari into the hoop. And there's the foul to try to stop the break. And that'll be a clear path to the basket. Two free throws coming up. And they'll retain possession.
His versatility, at least for Gallinari, is something that's so important for coaches to utilize. He's capable of stretching the floor the way he shoots it.
41 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Nice ball movement by Boston. Smart, wide open, he fires. Again, the miss by the Celtics. Here's Miracle Man. Tries again. ABC's shot is good.
There he is, beasting on the glass, converting the opportunity, trying to put this game away.
Number six.
I just don't see how you climb third back into the game foul when you're allowing plays like that to happen. Extra work on the offensive glass.
And both free throws good for White. 24 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Miracle Man. The second chance effort. And he sinks the layup.
Just creating havoc for the opponents the last few games.
You saw by that putback there, he's just completely locked in. Getting full contribution.
And so he's picked up his final foul, and he will sit for the rest of this game. And he can't hit the second. Passes it to Miracle Man. Here's DJ. Misses the three. And that's an intentional foul.
Wilson. Third.
And he makes the first.
At the line.
And both free throws good for White. Here's Miracle Man. A baseline J. No good. And so the road team gets the W in this one. To come into an opponent's building and dominate the way they did tonight, says I think Reagan.
Me and my money attached emotionally. I get the clutch, and if you get too close to me, I'm at the top where I'm supposed to be. Jumping in the game, like they coaching me. 400 rats ain't but a show to me. I'm on the road, and I bet that you're with me. When I'm in traffic, it's always a with me. Pillsbury, man, I keep door with me. Slide to the other side, it's always a man down. Draw down, hands in the air, make one move, get giving out so long, they don't even want to talk no more, they just run down. No lock doors, I serve with a. She was hanging with a op. We call her Mickey, talk to the.